Hello, I'm Daniel, and welcome to the Emunah Project. We here at the Emunah Project are continuing in our series of videos of information, education, inspiration, guidance, advice. And those who have been following my videos know that I am drawn to certain verses of the Torah that seem a little unusual or in some way problematic. And today, I'd like to mention something in the book of Genesis, chapter 9, verses 20 and 21, about Noah. Noah, the man of the earth, debased himself and planted a vineyard. He drank of the wine and became drunk. So Chazal seems to imply that the very act of planting a vineyard was unholy. He should have planted something else. We infer that that aside from the getting drunk, the very act of planting a vineyard was the result of some deficiency in Noah's character, and the drunkenness was merely an offshoot of that previous error, planting the vineyard. So I was struggling to understand this, why planting a vineyard was considered by our sages to be a sin. Wine can and is used for lofty purposes. It gladdens the heart. It's used on to celebrate. Our sages say, "Ein simcha b'lo yayin." There's no simcha. There's no rejoicing. There's no celebration without wine. We have wine. Wine was used to pour it on the altar, on the mizbeach. We use wine every week for Kiddush. We use wine every week for Havdalah. We use wine at a bris, at a circumcision. We use wine at a wedding. It's so why is Noah, it's puzzling me, why is Noah so harshly criticized for planting the vineyard? Sure, fine, he got drunk, he debased himself, he embarrassed himself. Okay, that's easily understood, but why is Chazal implying, why is our sages implying that the mere planting of the vineyard was in itself the result of some sort of a personality flaw? And I think, it says that Noah obtained the shoot from this vineyard, from Gan Eden, from the Garden of Eden. Similarly, Abraham, who planted a vineyard, got that shoot from the Garden of Eden. So, again, he's emulating God, who planted in the Garden of Eden. Abraham planted. So, what's with Noah? And I think the reason is that after the flood, and when Noah and his family disembarked and went after so long on dry land, the first thing he did was plant the vineyard. And I think the secret is there is power in how you begin things. Sure, he had to take with him stuff to start the new world. He had to provide for bread and everything for his family, for food, to starting the world, very much like Adam. Adam was the first person. Abraham was basically the first Jew. But Noah, the first thing Noah did was to plant the vineyard. And I think this is where Chazal is focusing. When you start, when you begin with something, it should be unambiguous. Wine, for all of its great qualities, and we use it for holy things, for kiddush, for weddings, for all these great things, has its dark side. It causes inebriation. It causes us to speak perhaps a little too freely. In vino veritas, there's truth in wine. You'll say things under the influence that you wouldn't dream of saying with a clear head and when you're sober. It loosens the inhibitions. You can become debased. You can do things that are quite horrible under the influence of alcohol. It can be a curse. I think what Chazal is saying is when you're beginning, when it's the first thing you're doing, you should perhaps have picked something else rather than wine. He should have picked something that didn't have such a dark side. The secret, I believe, is in the beginning. The fact that the first thing he went for was for the vineyard, that gave us perhaps a little insight into Noah and into ourselves. We begin things fresh. We begin things anew. We start relationships. We start pages in our lives. We start engagements, weddings. All these new things should be started new and fresh and in a good way. Do things right. And later we will reap the rewards. Do things improperly, and you reap what you sow. We're going to be doing more videos along these lines. Please come back. Please watch. Please learn. I hope you're learning from this. I hope you're getting inspired. I hope this is causing you to think and learn more. And until next time, on behalf of the Emunah Project, I'm Daniel, and thank you too much.